Jack them up, boys.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You know, the I Am, the great I Am, we belong to Him. We are His own. Hallelujah. I am everything He says I am. So that makes me able to do what I am called to do in spite of my weaknesses, because it's the great I Am that lives inside of me. So I operate out of His strength. Praise God. You know, so if there's anything you can't do because you feel a weakness is in your way, just put it to the side, because you can do, because the God who's more than enough lives on the inside of you. Amen? Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. That's why I'm able to be up here, in spite of my weaknesses. Amen? Thank you, Lord, that in my weakness, He is strong. Hallelujah. Before I want to get started tonight, Joyce McCroskey, which you all know, Joe and Joyce, she called me before I come over. Well, I knew before she left this afternoon. Her little granddaughter, Emma, which is JD's youngest daughter, is in Cook's Hospital. And she called and said that they took her to the emergency room this afternoon, and they ended up keeping her. And she called before we come over here tonight and wanted us to stand in agreement with her and Joe over their granddaughter, Emma. You know, there's no distance in prayer, because in the spirit we're all one, you know, there's no distance in the spirit. And she sees us as family, you know, we're her family. And so she's calling on her family, hallelujah. So Father, we just come before you tonight as a family. Father, we're in agreement with Joe and Joyce tonight, in Jesus' name, over little Emma. And I thank you, Father, that we lift her to you tonight, Lord. And we thank you, Father, that we stand on your word that by His stripes she is the healed. We come against any infection in the name of Jesus. And I thank you, Father, that she is whole from the top of her head to the very little tips of her toes, in Jesus' name. And Father, I speak peace over JD and Melissa, Father, that they can be in that room with her, and Father, that they know that all is well, in Jesus' name. Because I know that Joe and Joyce are standing in that place, that all is well, in Jesus' name. Amen? She's just a little thing. She's gone through so much since she's been born, and she's just, we've seen, from the time she was born, we've seen how God has touched her and brought her through so many different things. And I just know that God's not through with her. Hallelujah. Praise God. She is whole. And I hear tonight that Dick's being transferred back to Weatherford tomorrow. Hallelujah.
Yes, so Dick calls yesterday. He says, Pastor Kathleen, I need a miracle. I said, okay, Dick. He says, they won't let me go home. I need to get out of here on Friday. Yeah, I got to get out of here. And they won't let me out. So I called John. I told John, because I knew John was probably coming home from work. I said, hey, Dick needs a miracle. Can you go by and see him? So I told Dick. I prayed with him, but Dick couldn't hear me, you know. And so I told Dick, though, I said, you call me tomorrow because I'm expecting a miracle. And so he called today. Pastor Kathleen, I'm leaving. I'm going to Holland Lake tomorrow. Tell all my friends.
Family. Thank you, Lord. How many, I'm just going to go with that. How many people here tonight know of someone, family member, close friend, that's needing healing in their bodies? Needs a healing in their body. And that healing could be anything from just a flu bug to something terminal. If that's you, just stand up. Well, let's just all stand up. Just all stand up. Praise the Lord. We are family. And Father, we come together tonight in the name of Jesus as a family, most importantly, Lord, as the body of Christ, as children of the Most High God. And Father, we lift everyone that raised their hands tonight to you, Lord, in the name of Jesus. And we declare tonight that not one weapon formed or fashioned against them, spirit, soul, or body, in Jesus' name, will prosper. I thank you, Father, we call and declare them tonight healed and whole from the top of their heads to the tips of their toes in Jesus' name. Father, I declare in Jesus' name, no sickness nor disease can remain in their bodies in the name of Jesus. We declare it so in the name of Jesus. This night, March 15th, 2017. Amen? And I expect to hear reports. I expect to hear the suddenlies in the name of Jesus. Suddenly. Hallelujah. Jesus went to the cross and bore that for us. It's settled in heaven, and it's settled within our spirits tonight in Jesus' name. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. It is a good day. This is a good day. Hallelujah. This is the day that the Lord has made. And we will rejoice and be glad in it. Hallelujah. He has set us free. Glory be to God. All right. You can be seated if you want. Thank you, Jesus, that the church hears testimony after testimony after testimony after testimony over what God is doing in each of our lives. Hallelujah. That we're hearing more praise reports than we are needing prayer reports. Hallelujah. Those things that God has done and accomplished for each of us. In Jesus' name, whether it's a physical ailment or whether it's a financial whatever, God has taken care of it because he is the God of more than enough. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord, that we are a church ready. We say, I'm ready. We are ready. Hallelujah. We are ready for every person that walks through those doors. We're ready. In Jesus' name. We're fully equipped in Jesus' name. We're filled with the wisdom of God in Jesus' name. We are in the seeing and we are in the knowing at all times in Jesus' name. In spite of how much word you may know or may not know, it does not matter. The Holy Spirit within you is all that you need. And I say that in the sense of, you know, we just have to rely on the Holy Ghost because there's always something that we don't know. But because of the Holy Spirit that lives within us, we're in the knowing. To be able to get to that place, to totally be able to rely on God for all things, whether we know it or whether we don't know it, because of the Holy Spirit that lives within us, leading us and guiding us into all truth. And in knowing that, whatever weakness you may have, whatever thought that you don't think you're worthy, does not matter. Because you are a child of the Most High God. It does not matter what you know in the natural. I say that by the Spirit of God, because that limits us. You got to go deep. You know, when you don't know, thank God that God gave us the Holy Ghost for what we don't know in the natural, that we can go deep in the Spirit of God through prayer, and God can bring them up out of you and declare and speak the Word of God through you. The words of wisdom, the word of knowledge, the gifts of the Holy Ghost, hallelujah, to benefit those around about you and to benefit you. Forget not all his benefits. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for the Holy Ghost, Father. Thank you, Lord, that our eyes and our hearts and our ears, our spirit man, our mind, Father, has been opened up to the revelation that the Holy Ghost is for us today. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, that the Holy Spirit is within us, leading us and guiding us into all truth. Father, whether we feel it or not, Father, that we come to that place. We just pull up our bootstraps, Father. We just tighten them up in Jesus' name. And we rely, Father, that the Holy Ghost that is within us will not fail us. Thank you, Jesus. Just like Dick called and said he needed that miracle, Lord, you did not fail him. Hallelujah. Father, that we recognize you not just in the big things, but in all things. In those little itty-bitty places, Father, that we recognize you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We bless your name. We lift you up. You are worthy, Father. You are worthy, Jesus. We thank you that you are the glory and you are the lifter of our heads tonight. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. The lifter. That we're not downtrodden, but you are the lifter of our heads. That we can lift our heads and praise you, Father, regardless of what's going on around us. We lift our hearts to you in praise in Jesus' name. And Father, we know that the Word of God declares that praise stills the enemy. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Ele bronda le stara bacasede, ile orastianda labrasne, ilastora bashi kile ostande, inanande le broshni anda la casor, ilastora bashe, we stir ourselves up de le stande, inandorastibile ele kia la sora, inabade estela, here we stir ourselves up. On the internet, stir yourselves up. Ile yostora bashi, wrap yourselves up. Ile shtora bandele, embrace the Holy Ghost. Ile ishne mandile shtora. Ele brandile kosanda la brandi estande. Ola shniandele brosada. Ida lo koshta la brastele ete asa. We purpose dele brondo. Ile asi braha ha le ilo sorati. Kilashi adala stora. Ido lo sotora stela bra. Yestela, epidos. Hallelujah. Oh, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. We bring it up. We bring it up and out in Jesus' name. Oh, brasa those mysteries. Those things that you would have us do in this church as a body. Father, those things that you would have us do in the arena. Those things that you would have us do in the youth. Those things that you would have us do with the children, Father. We bring it up and out in Jesus' name. That you're speaking it to the hearts of every person here. Father, their place that you would have them in the those things that you would have them do to help equip those God ideas, those creative ideas in the name of Jesus. Father, we're not just sitting around just doodling, Father, but that we are pursuing in Jesus' name. Touching lives, changing lives. Father, building the kingdom of God for such a time as this. Hallelujah. Those things that you hear your spirit say, those things that you hear your spirit say, write them down if you, bring it to lebrasa talabrande, so you stora. Yaste la castonde, inamasoto, every word de lebrasa. Ha ha, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. That you're preparing us for yourself, Lord, a glorious body, that will shake off every cord and every hindrance that has fastened itself upon it. Every weight will be removed so your body can move in power and great glory and great anointing. Hallelujah. Father, we are a church. We are a mighty army. Hallelujah. Sweeping over this area of Weatherford, Father, reaching out and touching lives in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. We serve the great Redeemer, don't we? Hallelujah. We have been redeemed. He is the potter. We are the clay. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father, that you're molding us and shaping us into that thing, into that person you would have us be. Let us see that person that you would have us be. You see it, Lord. Let us see. Let me see what you would have me be. Hallelujah. I mean, I know that I'm a child of God. I know that I'm filled with the Holy Ghost. But Lord, take me further into what you want me to be. In spite of my weaknesses. Hallelujah. Take me beyond that it's not holding us back. That we're touching lives, and because of that, people will see that, and people's lives will be changed as a result of that. Your children's lives will be changed as a result of that. Your grandchildren's lives will be changed as a result of that. They'll be able to walk out in what they're called to be, to walk out in, because they see you walking out in that very thing. If they can't see you walking out in the power of God, how do you expect them to follow suit? I mean, we have some powerful children here, don't get me wrong. We need to learn from our children, because sometimes they're walking out and stronger than we are. Do you hear what I'm saying? Let us reflect and just embrace one another. Hallelujah. Glean from one another. Sharpen one another. Amen. Not tear one another down. I'm not saying that we do that. I'm just saying. Not to tear one another down, but to always remember to build, encourage, and lift one another up. There's enough tearing down out there in the world. It doesn't need to be in the church. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Father, we lift up the president. We lift up his cabinet. We lift it up in the name of Jesus. Eleandra Bandesh Nemi Lasuraba, Ileste, Casandaleste, Ilestorabashne, Ele Seterebro, Nida La Candolo, Holy Ghost wisdom, Holy Ghost direction, Ileshtala Brande, Holy Ghost protection, Ele Mandale, Irihiste, every tongue that would rise up against will be the one showed to be in the wrong, in the name of Jesus. Do we declare unity in this nation in Jesus' name? One nation under God in the name of Jesus. Enemy, we steal you in the name of Jesus. You be still. Hallelujah. Not to let our guard down, church, over our nation. This is the nation's greatest hour. It's its greatest time of a spiritual outpouring. It's its greatest time of a spiritual and a financial blessing like never before. And the enemy is trying to stop it through division and strife and chaos in our streets. And, well, I declare peace. Amen. Hallelujah. It's just, praise the Lord. Thank you, Lord, that the church is not growing weaker. It's growing stronger and stronger and stronger and stronger and stronger and stronger. Thank you, Father. We just declare a fresh visitation of you, Jesus, from heaven. I declare a fresh visitation from heaven to the United States of America. In the name of Jesus, Hallelujah. A visitation. Thank you, Lord. A sweet, loving, embracing visitation in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. And any nation or country that would want to raise up its ugly head against us, bow your knee in Jesus' name. North Korea, you bow your knee. That spiritual wickedness above that nation, I come against that stronghold in the name of Jesus, and I declare victory in the heavenlies over that nation in the name of Jesus. Because God would not want anyone in that nation to perish either. Hallelujah. We declare freedom. We declare the love of God would come into that nation, a visitation from heaven in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. You know, I know it's the end times. And I know there's things that are coming to pass as a result of the end times. But I say to you, as long as the church is in this world, we have authority over the enemy in Jesus' name. Amen. We have authority over destruction in Jesus' name. We have authority over that spirit of death and murdering and evil in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. 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 Don't we?
Yes.
If we don't, then why are we here? What authority do we have? How much power do we carry if we cannot still the enemy now? Why, we're still here. Amen? Well, we might as well just close the book and go home. God uses us today. Amen? It's not over. Hallelujah. We win. And we want to take as many people with us when we go. And there are those that look ugly, 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 but God loves them. And there's a way where there seems to be no way. God met you somewhere along the way, and your heart was open to receive. Amen? Thank God. Say, thank you, Jesus. He first found me. Hallelujah. And he kept after me until he got me. Some take a little longer than others. But God's still going. God's going after him. There's somebody that he'll set in their path that they'll hear. Y'all, you think you want it to be you, you know. But when that day comes to where that seed has finally come to pass, and they say, yes, Lord, come into my heart, they're going to remember when you said what you said. Even though it may take Fred to bring them, they're going to remember what you said. I remember my brother always saying, Gloria, When I come to that place of wanting Jesus, I know who to come to. But I know there's somebody going to walk across his path that's going to he's going to say, oh my goodness, Jesus, come into my life. And then he's going to walk into my life and he's going to say, Gloria, I remember what you said. And now I'm coming to tell you. Hallelujah! Praise the Lord. Don't give up.
Praise the Lord.
on anyone that you want to see come to see Jesus, because they're going to come. Amen. They're a part of your household. Hallelujah. They're a part of somebody's household.
Promise.
Thank you, Jesus. That's why I said I've told it before. You know, I had the honor and the privilege of leading every one of my grandparents to Jesus before they died, except for my father or my mother's dad. And it's because he died when she was 9. But every grandparent called me up and asked me to come. And I didn't even know, and I really hadn't ever said anything to any of them. They just saw my life. And they were listening more than I thought when I was just around talking, you know. And I remember my dad's father. He was in a nursing home, and his name was Walter. And he calls. He has a nursing home call me, and he said, and they call me, and they said, "Your grandpa wants you to come see him." I said, "Okay." So I go up there. I go into his room. I don't remember how old I was. I mean, I was an adult. And I go into his room, and he says, "Come sit beside me." And I said, "Okay." And he goes, "I want you to lead me to Jesus." I didn't even realize at the time that he'd even been even listening. But somewhere along the way, or my dad talking about it, or, you know, Gloria's at it again, or whatever. You know, a seed was planted. And so I said, "Well, yes, Grandpa. I'd be honored to lead you." And so I did. He died 3 days later. You just don't know. You know, my grandma, she was at my mom's, my dad's mother, and she tugged at me, and she says, "Tell me about this Jesus. I want to know Jesus." And then my other grandma, she calls me, and I mean, it was like days later they died. You know, but it was like, oh my gosh. But I just felt honored that I was able to lead all three of them. And I really believe that I would have led the other one too if he had lived long. But unfortunately, I just praise that he's there too. Somewhere along the way, someone introduced him to Jesus. Amen? Amen. I don't know why I went there, but it's for someone. Don't ever give up. Whether God uses you or God uses someone else, God's going to use someone. Hallelujah. And you're going to know. They're going to let you know. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Father. Lord, I just thank you for every loved one that is being lifted up to you to receive Jesus. Receives Jesus. I thank you, Lord, that you're leading and guiding those special ones to cross each and every one's path, to speak a word into their heart, Father, because it's due season. It's harvest time, the great outpouring in the name of Jesus. And I thank you, Lord, that we're going to begin to hear day after day after day of those ones, Father, that we have stood for such a time to hear a phone call, a letter, an email, a text, and they're going to let us know that they know Jesus, that they've accepted you, Father. They've accepted him as their Lord and their Savior. Hallelujah. That heaven is growing, growing, growing. Amen? Amen? Heaven, the kingdom of God is bigger than the kingdom of hell. In Jesus' name. I believe there's more populated in heaven than hell. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. We lift up Pastor Dave and, Father, all that he's doing in Israel. I thank you, Father, that for your continued protection upon him. I thank you, Father, that you're leading him and guiding him. I thank you, Father, that he's bringing that word of encouragement, those words of edification, the word of God, Father, to those around about him in Jesus' name. Father, that he's opening up that word to those people around about him in Jesus' name. Father, that he's going to come home with great testimonies in the name of Jesus, that it's going to be the best visit he's had in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. You blessed him above and beyond what he could ask or think. And I thank you, Father, for it. He's going to come home with a new fresh anointing. I was trying to think of a new passion, a revived passion, Father, in the name of Jesus, for your word. Hallelujah. Stir him up. Hallelujah. Fire, a fresh fire coming out of him, Father, in the name of Jesus. Amen, Kathleen. Just a fresh fire. Hallelujah. Don't y'all need fresh fire? Hallelujah. Fresh fire. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord, that you are the King of Kings and that you are the Lord of Lords. And I thank you, Father, for every door that you're opening, every door that we're walking through, that fresh anointing, that fresh vision, that fresh direction, that freshness, Father, that newness, Lord, springing forth, placing us into areas, Lord, that are just above and beyond, Father, what we could ask or think. That's going to enlarge and put us in an even better place within this body of believers than ever before. In Jesus' name. Amen. We're not limited. We're unlimited because of the God that lives with us. Amen. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. 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 Grace and peace be multiplied unto each and every one of you. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I think I'm done. Hallelujah. It's a good day. Amen. I'm glad y'all come out. I told Kathleen, I'm probably already turned off, maybe. Anyway, praise the Lord. Amen.
As you've watched today, you've had the opportunity to hear the word preached. And as you apply that word, you'll get victory in your life. But it has to start someplace. It has to start first with a commitment to Jesus Christ as making him your Savior, and then making him the Lord of your life. Paul said this in Romans 10, 8 through 10. It says, "But what does it say? The word is near you, and it's in your mouth and in your heart. That is the word of faith which we preach." Well, the word of faith that Paul preached is found in the next verses. It says that if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, then you'll be saved. For with the mouth confession is made unto salvation, and with the heart one believes unto righteousness. So it goes like this. All you have to do is actually say, "Jesus is my Savior, and he is my Lord." So I'm going to invite you to say this with me this morning. And if you want to bow your head, you can bow your head. The Bible says that pray watching, and so it's okay to keep your eyes open and watch. But let's say this together. Say, "Father, I know that you sent Jesus to die for my sins. I confess those sins today. I ask you, Jesus, to forgive me of those sins and to come into my heart and be my Savior. And I commit today that I will make you the Lord of my life. Thank you for salvation today. In the name of Jesus, amen." If you said that today for the first time, no matter what time of the day or night it is, welcome to the family. Welcome to knowing Jesus Christ as your Savior. Now from this day on, make Him the Lord of your life. And as you make Him the Lord of your life, you will find out what God can do in you and through you. Also, if you've watched this broadcast, we want you to know that you can become a partner with this ministry. As you become a partner with this ministry, some of the things that you've seen throughout this presentation, the buckouts and things like that, then you become a part of that kind of ministry. And there's many people that come to know Jesus. We have offices in Nigeria and Togo, have 4 churches in Nigeria, 1 in Togo. And we want you to know that you become a part of each and everything that this ministry does when you become a partner. You can see the information right there on your screen so that you're able to become a covenant partner with us. And as you do, we want you to know that we pray over each and every one of your offerings so that God will multiply it back to your hands according to His Word. His Word says in Luke 6:38 that He gives back, pressed down, shaken together, running over to make room for more. The New Living Translation says whatever measure you use in giving, large or small, it'll be used to measure what is given back to you. So we want you to know that God loves you. He'll take care of you, and He'll multiply the seed that you sow in this ground with this ministry. Remember that Jesus is Lord, and Jesus loves you, and so do we.